Akbar the Great biography. Akbar was the third and the greatest Mughal emperor. Parents, Jamayu, father, and Hamida Banu Begum, mother, religion, Islam, Sunni, Dinai Ilahi. He was the son of Nasiruddin Humayu and succeeded him as the emperor in the year 1556, at the tender age of just 13. Succeeding his father Humayu at a critical stage, he slowly enlarged the extent of the Mughal Empire to include almost all of the Indian subcontinent. He extended his power and influence over the entire country due to his military, political, cultural, and economic dominance. He established a centralized system of administration and adopted a policy of marriage alliance and diplomacy. With his religious policies, he won the support of his non-Muslim subjects as well. He was one of the greatest emperors of the Mughal dynasty and extended his patronage to art and culture. Akbar, thus, laid the foundations for a multicultural empire during his reign. Akbar was born as Abul Fath Jalaluddin Muhammad at the Umakot Fort in Sindh on October 15, 1542. He and his wife Hamida Banu Begum, who was pregnant at that time, was granted refuge by the Hindu ruler Rana Prasad. In 1555, Humayun recaptured Delhi with the military support of the Persian ruler Shah Timur. Akbar was 13 years old at that time and Humayun's trusted General Behram Khan took up the post of regent for the young emperor. Akbar succeeded Humayun on February 14, 1556 in Kalanaur, Punjab, and was proclaimed Shahinshah. Behram Khan ruled on behalf of the young emperor till he came of age. At the time of his ascent to the Mughal throne, Akbar's empire encompassed Kabul, Kandahar, Delhi and parts of Punjab. But the Afghan Sultan Muhammad Adil Shah of Tanna had designs on the throne of India and planned to wage war against the Mughals. The Mughal army faced a humiliating defeat and they soon receded with their leader, Commander Teddy Beg absconding. On the direction of his regent Behram Khan, Akbar declared his intentions to reclaim his rights to the throne at Delhi. The Mughal forces moved to Panipat through Taneshwar and faced Hema's army on November 5, 1556. Behram Khan led the Mughal army from the back and placed skilled generals on the front, left and right flanks. Mughal soldiers pursued Hema, captured him and brought him before Akbar. The Second Battle of Panipat marked the beginning of the glory days for the Mughal reign in India. Akbar sought out to end Afghan sovereignties that might be claimant for the throne in Delhi. Hema's relatives were captured and imprisoned by Behram Khan. Akbar dedicated the first decade of his rule towards expanding his empire. Under the regency of Behram Khan, Ajmer, Malwa and Gurkhatunga were annexed into the Mughal territories. Akbar's forces met a formidable opponent in the young king's mother, Rani Durgavati, a Rajput warrior queen. Beginning in 1561, Akbar started his quest to conquer Rajputana. He employed force as well as diplomatic tactics to make the Rajput rulers submit to his rule. This presented a problem for Akbar on his designs to establish unquestioned supremacy over the region. Ul Singh's chiefs Chimal and Puttah held off the Mughal forces for 4 months in 1568. The Mughal army led by General Mir Mosim also conquered parts of Baluchistan around Quetta and Mekrar by 1595. By 1600, Akbar had captured Burhanpur, Asirgarh Fort, and Khandesh. The principles of Akbar's administration were based on moral as well as material welfare of his subjects. The entire empire was divided into 15 subahs, each province being governed by a subadar along with other regional posts mirroring that in the center. Akbar also introduced the custom of taking roll of the soldiers and branding of horses. The emperor maintained ultimate control over the military and excelled in the ability to enforce discipline among his troops. Land revenue was the chief source of income for the Mughal government, and Akbar introduced several reforms in the revenue department. All these reforms greatly increased productivity and revenue of the Mughal Empire, leading to prosperous subjects with abundance of food. Akbar introduced reforms in judicial system as well, and for the first time, Hindu customs and laws were referred to in case of Hindu subjects. Akbar was probably the first Islamic ruler in India who sought stable political alliances through matrimony. Political significance of these alliances was far-reaching for the Mughal Empire in securing strong loyalty of these dynasties. This practice brought the Hindu and Muslim nobilities in close contact, securing a better secular environment for the empire. The Rajput alliances became strongest allies of Akbar's army, which proved crucial in many of his subsequent conquests, like that in Gujarat in 1572. Another contributing factor was Emperor Akbar's relations with the Ottoman Empire. Akbar became a follower of the great Sufi mystic Sheikh Mohinuddin Chishti and made several pilgrimages to his shrine at Ajmer. Akbar was a great patron of art and culture. Although he himself could not read and write, he would appoint people who read to him various topics of art, history, philosophy, and religion.